Okay. I was right. We can find Nightshade here, which is absolutely wonderful. Now we just need to know where to find fireflies. Now they're called sunset fireflies. Does that mean they only show up at sunset? I hope not. Because otherwise, if that's the case, that'll make things a little bit tricky. Also, they might not show up in the rain. That seems decently likely. Yeah, so it was this person who was talking about fireflies before. Okay. Yeah, I thought this person said something about fireflies. That's why I came over here, but it's possible that the rain is preventing me from finding them. Or it's possible that they're somewhere else rather than the village. I haven't found any fireflies. I found a Korok again. Next time I find a firefly like that, I think I do need to take a picture of it. That way I can track it. Should probably do the same with other things.
I'm worried about the farmers in Kakariko Village. They grow pumpkins and carrots. It's sort of their specialty. But I hear there's a little war going on between them.
War between pumpkins and carrots? What are you talking about? Huh? They're fighting over whether carrots or pumpkins should be their official vegetable?
I don't worry about them.
Okay. Well, I can't seem to find... I can't seem to find these fireflies. So, I am just gonna head back to where we were. And I know we can't stay up there for very long, so I'm gonna need to immediately start gliding somewhere. And I guess I'm gonna glide towards the other tower. That's what we're gonna do. Because I do want to grab these towers, at the very least. Wait, no, I lied. We need to go to the Shrine of Resurrection. I forgot. Well, not that specifically, but the place near it. So that we can turn in our orbs. Wait, no, can't we do that at Kakariko Village as well? Wasn't that something we could do? I don't think I even need to go all the way back here. Hold on, I'll go back to I'm all over the place. I'm forgetting how things work here. But I think you can also turn them in at the shrine at Kakariko Village. So let me go do that there actually instead. That way I have less of a distance to run. Okay, here we are. Let's try this. You who have conquered the shrines and claimed the spirit orbs in exchange for 4, I'll amplify your being, stamina vessel. Very nice. More stamina, more better. Cool. Almost another full ring. Go and bring peace to Hyrule. You can't tell me what to do. What if I want to bring chaos to Hyrule? That also sounds fun. Okay. Now we're going back here and heading to the next tower. There's just so much to explore in between the towers as well that we're gonna need to do. But my first priority is just opening up the map so I can at least see what there is to see. And then we'll go back and comb through the areas. Okay, well, now we jump. There's that tower. I won't be able to fly all the way to that rock, so I'm gonna fly over here. Oh, it's water down there. I see there's a shrine over there. I thought that was some sort of encampment, but hard to tell what it is. Doesn't help that the resolution in this game is fixed for like 720p or 1080p or I don't know what it is. Something not ideal. that prevents me from seeing clearly in the distance. Actually, I forgot I can just do this. Yeah, what am I looking at? So, those don't look like bokoblin things. So, I don't know. Oh, this is suspicious. Doesn't seem to be breaking. What are those down there? They're green. Are they just green Lizalfos? Guess so. They're all down there waiting to ambush somebody. I wonder if you get a way to manipulate the wind at some point. Because the direction of the wind seemed to very much dictate how far I could go in that gliding challenge. It wasn't just my stamina. Great view from up here. So, those wolves do that, but do you actually attack me? It doesn't seem like they actually attack me. Right? Or are you? No, okay, you do actually attack me. Oh, okay, just slimes. Never mind. I was worried for a second, but it's just slimes. I have so much blue chew jelly at this point. I don't really know what to do with it. Maybe if we meet that potion master in the Skull Lake, they'll give us an idea. Dude, can we see that yet? Is there a skull-shaped lake yet? I don't think that's skull-shaped. Okay, we're entering into what appears to be a snowy area, which is actually bad. So that means I'm gonna have to put on this. It'll help us out a little bit. But I'm probably gonna have to use some sorts of food as well. Fortunately, I think we are pretty well stocked up on that kind of stuff. Yeah, what is that down there? What? Rocks. Hello, rocks. I'm gonna need stasis, aren't I? Who threw that? Weird. Strange noises. As long as rocks don't suddenly drop from the sky out of nowhere, I think we'll be okay. What? Why combat music? What are we in combat with? I don't see anything. Okay, so we've gotten into an area where it is indeed too cold. So, what do we got here? Sauteed peppers, spicy stuff, steak. Let's see. Let's start with just this one. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. Let's start with just this one. There we go. And see how far that gets us. I don't think we need a whole 12 minutes. We probably will need more than 3 minutes, though, if we need to get to the very top of that tower. Oh, it's an ice guy. Stay away from him. We're not ready for that yet. Again, this is definitely an area that I'm not supposed to quite be in yet. My equipment. I think we do need at some point find equipment that lets us survive in this cold without having to just eat a bunch of food. Interesting. Korok? Yep, Korok. Okay. Yes, yes, I found you. Thank you, thank you. So, the Koroks... The one that... The very first Korok that I found, they told me about some specific Korok that I needed to go find. That Korok is probably in a forested area. So I should probably go find wherever the most dense forest is in order to find it. But that'll probably be easiest once I actually have... thanks for the seared steak. Once I've actually unlocked all the map. So that's still going to be my current priority. I wanted to mine this. Give me all the stuff, give me all the stuff. Give me all the stuff. Some stuff fell down. I want it. I need it. I need it. Give me the sapphire. There we go. It's all worth it in the end, surely. So far, the only use I've found for that stuff, though, is just to color your equipment. Oh, I probably should have taken a picture of that. That seems like something I haven't seen much of. Herba Tower. Herba Trower, or something like that. Can I not climb this? I can't. Oh, gosh. This is a problem, isn't it? Oh, no. Can I not... I'm gonna run out of cold resistance here soon. And I'm not gonna be able to get up here unless I have some sort of fire ability. I can't even speak. I have fire arrows. Will those help me here? Let's see. I'll get out our bow, get out fire arrows. Thank goodness that that worked. Okay, is that enough space for me to get by? Not quite. Okay, that's enough space. Now let's climb. Running out of cold resistance here. That's okay. Let's just let it run out. At this point, we can make it to the top with our remaining health, along with the new Mipha's blessing that regenerated. So we're gonna not waste any of our cold resistance food. Almost there. There we go. It helps that we have so much stamina. We can do that so much quicker. Alright, another tower activated. I think there's only maybe, what, two towers left for us to grab? I think that's right. Okay, so this is the top left corner of the map. Actually, there is something interesting there. There's that pyramid. That looks... I want to go to that. I'm curious about that immediately. Or is that like a maze? Like, what was that? Hold on. What is this? It's like it's a maze of some sort, or it's a pyramid. I can't tell which. But I want to go there. And that is actually not related, it seems, to any of the divine beasts. Because one of the divine beasts is over here, right? And then the other divine beast is way down here. And then the last divine beast is right over here. None of the divine beasts are at whatever the heck this thing is. So I'm incredibly curious about that. And it looks like we have got... Yeah, no, wait. We've got more. Not just two. I think four. Four more areas to unlock. Because there's all these areas back here. I know this one is a snowy mountain, I think. But this, I don't know. So that's going to be really interesting. But for now, I'm going to... see if I can fly towards wherever that thing was. Oh, wait, actually, even if we jump down from here, it might be too cold still. Well, it is what it is. I want to go there. I want to find out. I want to see how far we can get. Let's see. Is there any chance that we'll be able to reach there? Okay, so it's on the other side of that hill right there. I think we can make that happen. We're just gonna need to use some more food, I guess. Or just tank it and rely on Mipha's blessing. Very empty area with these two shrines, seemingly. But we'll see when we get to the ground. It looks like we've got some wolves. Okay, there we go. What is that sound? Oh, it's just a wolf, okay. Anyways, let's see. If we're gonna go into that shrine, we don't need any resistance food just yet. So let's just eat the roasted bass. See if we can get in here. What is that? The campfire over there too, to get warm. Rinoya Shrine. Okay, we'll take a look at that in a second. Let's do the shrine first, if we can. Skip the cutscenes, as always. We've already seen this stuff. Things that can be logged include wildlife, monsters, ingredients, and weapons. Got it. Yeah, we're gonna need to... I need to remember to do more of that. Just in case we need to search for stuff later. Okay, so we got an orb. Directing the wind. Okay, but I don't think that has to do with any kind of ability that we have. So I've got this orb, and if I drop that down there, I want it to go into that, right? Is that the idea? Like, is that what I'm doing here? It is. And that makes that go up. So I'm assuming I need to be on that thing when it goes up. So I don't want this thing in here right now, but I need it to eventually get up there. Is that the idea? Like, I need to toss it like that and then run? Except that's not going to be enough. So I need to make it go a little bit further. I think that's it. But can't I just... Hold on. Can't I just do this? Like, why does that matter? I can just block that off. Like, what's the point of the rest of this stuff in that case, though? Because there's a lot of extra fans here and extra blocks. But what's the point of any of that? Can't I just do this? Place this right here. Then go over here. I'll take this with me just in case I need it for something. I don't know. I don't know if I need it, but we'll keep it. There we go. And then I can just move this. Like, isn't that all there is to it? Are you gonna move? Is it gonna move? Oh, it's not. Not gonna move. Well, I can push it. So that doesn't matter. There we go. Cool. Okay, I mean, that was an incredibly easy one. I guess that's it. There's a lot of extra stuff there that I'm not sure what the purpose was. It seems like that one is... They were hoping that you overcomplicated things? I don't know. Regardless, there's our spirit orb. Which is cool, but most importantly, this is a teleport waypoint. So we can teleport over here now if we need to. That's, in my opinion, the most important thing about these various shrines. Crouch down so you can approach it quietly. Take heed though, the horse notices you when you're directly behind it, it will kick you. Yeah, but the thing I want to know is how I actually permanently get a horse, if that's even possible. Okay, hold on. Before anything else, this seems... No, I didn't want to... Oh my gosh, I'm gonna... No! What am I doing? Okay, well, that... It's not what I'm trying to do. No. No, I need... Spicy pepper. There we go. Allow me to search for spicy peppers. Thank you. Because I feel like that is going to be important. I can't believe I just wasted a fire arrow. That is very lame. Okay. So, you know what? I think I need a torch. I think that's what I actually need. I have a feeling that would solve all my issues if I just had a torch. Solve all my cold issues. Soldier Shield. A shield once used by the guards of Hyrule Castle. It's easy to handle, but its core is made of wood, so it can catch fire. Can't carry anymore. Well, I'll leave it there. I already took this guy's spear. This is not a very good spear, but I guess it's as good as we're gonna get. Hello there. Hey! Is this Beetle? It is Beetle! Hey, I don't believe I've made your acquaintance. Do you sell me those pears that allow me to control birds? The name's Beetle, but you can call me? Actually, let's just stick with Beetle. But even if you forget my face, you can remember me by my beetle-shaped backpack. No, don't worry, I remembered your face, buddy. I remember you. Beetle, he's one of my favorite characters. Despite these dangerous times, you'll find me traveling all over Hyrule to fulfill your shopping needs. Really? He appears in other places? I stock many special bugs and must-have items for travelers, but I always charge a fair price, or my name's not Beetle. Unfortunately, I don't think I have too much money left right now, but we'll see what I can buy. I also buy all sorts of things if you're in need of rupees. Gemstones in particular fetch a high price. Oh, how can I help you today? So he pays an especially high price for gemstones? Let's see what we can sell him. What would you like to sell? Let's see. Okay, it doesn't seem like it's an especially high price. Okay, the blue ones seem very common for the chew jelly. I don't know if I need to sell anything. I can get infinite money after all. Let's just see what he has to sell first. Maybe there's something I need to buy. Oh, wait. Well, yeah, actually, I will probably take some arrows, but not just yet. Okay, hold on. So, he's got 20 arrows in stock for 6 rupees each. Or he's got one bundle of 10 for 45 rupees. So if we bought 10 of the regular arrows, that would be 60 rupees. Okay, so it is cheaper to buy them in bulk. But what else is there? Hold on. Summer Wing Butterfly. Absorbs the warmth of the sun. Makes you feel warm and fuzzy. Okay, that would be useful, I guess, in the current area we're in. Same with the Warm Darner. The Tireless Frog. Okay. He honestly doesn't sell anything that important, but I will buy arrows. Oh, sorry. I know you're out of that. Okay. And we are actually going to try to buy even more arrows, I think. So if we buy all 20, what, that's 120 rupees? I don't even care. I'll buy it. Yep. Okay. Thanks for the business. Do you need anything else? Nope. Thank you very much. Hope to see you again soon. Okay, let me get inside. Still cold in here? Danton. It must be so great. You know what I'm talking about, right? Yeah, it must be so great. I agree. Whoa. I knew you would. It's every dreamer's dearest dream, isn't it? Having a sword that shoots light all wham and mows down all kinds of monsters like a pow? That'd be amazing. I mean, even in the name, a sword that seals the darkness. It's just the coolest thing ever. Oh? Is that what the pyramid thing is about? Monkton. Traveler, eh? Can you spare me a minute to listen to a bored old retiree tell a story? Sure. When you get to be my age, you start reminiscing about all the memories from your childhood. To be honest, growing up out in the middle of nowhere, well, there weren't really other good kids around, or other kids around. My only friends were Harry and Mary. I remember playing with Harry out in the maze and Mary out by the ruins. The maze. Okay, so it is a maze. Tell me about Harry. There's an enormous maze beyond Tabantha Tundra just north of here. I don't know who built it or when. The adults always said not to go near it. They said it was too dangerous there. One
Friday hired Harry to go into the maze as a test of courage. I never saw him again.
Okay, that's a dark story.
I learned the hard way that it really is dangerous there. Children have no real sense of danger, I suppose. Mm. But this day, the mere memory breaks my heart.
Yeah, I mean, you kind of got him killed. That's very unfortunate. Yeah, let me hear his other story, though. Yes, yes, yes. The ruins. So tell me about the ruins.
Maybe you've seen the big canyon to the southeast. There are some secret ruins down at the base of that valley. I don't know who built them or when. The adults always said not to go near. They said it was too dangerous there. One day, Mary and I went out there to explore and search the ruins. In the blink of an eye, Mary lost her footing. She slipped and tumbled down the cliff. I never saw her again. Sometimes a child's innocent curiosity can cause tragedies that can never be taken back.
Your parents should have kept a bit a closer leash on you, especially after one child had died. They still let you go and run off to mazes and cliffs and whatnot?
That memory will haunt me until my dying day. As I grew older, I learned to overcome my grief over losing them. You can't change the past, only the future. Harry and Mary never made it back, but two of their descendants are in that stall over there. My only friends out in these parts were horses, you see. I suppose that's still true to this day.
Goodness gracious.
Hi.
Vark. Welcome. Will you be staying with us? A regular bed will cost you 20 rupees. Soft bed is 40. No. We're good. Come see us again. Okay. You got a... Okay, you have a quest. We don't have time for a quest. We're dying here. I guess I'll steal all your wood, sure. But... Hold on. Wait, what's this? Double axe. This double-sided axe was designed with fighting in mind. It's a bit unwieldy, so it requires a well-practiced technique to use efficiently. Cool and all, where is a torch? Has anybody got a torch? Wildberry. Should have taken a picture of those, but I'm still freezing to death, so I'm a bit worried. Torch? Torch? Anybody got a torch? Okay, no one's got a torch. Fine. I guess I'm continuing on over towards where the pyramid, where I saw the pyramid. Just gonna go across the plains. It's gonna be quite a journey. Let's see, what do I want to use? We are gonna use some kind of food to help us out here. Just a question of which one. I think this should be okay. That might be enough. Let's see. 5 more minutes. I'm just hoping that the pyramid isn't in a cold area. Oh my goodness. Bye. No, I'm gonna die. No. Run. Stop. Why are you so fast? Oh my goodness. Okay. Please stop. Please stop. Okay, this place is a lot more dangerous when you're not flying over it. I'm fortunate that I can outrun these people. And it's not due to my enhanced stamina, it's due to just normal stamina regeneration. Okay. Please stop. Oh no. What's happening? Why is it red? Oh my gosh, what's happening? What? Oh, it's the red sun rises. Blood has been spilt this day. Okay, sure.
Blood moon rises once again.
Yeah, the people are respawning. Sure. That freaks me out every time. Why do they have to do that? Why does it have to be so creepy when the enemy's respawn time comes around? What on earth? Let's just keep moving. So there's the other shrine. I guess I'll go head over to that before anything. Oh, man, but if I do that, I'm going to lose some of my cold resistance. Oh, it'll be wasted because... Well, I guess I can unlock it, right? I don't have to actually do the shrine yet. I'll just unlock it as a teleport, and then I'll continue on to the maze. Oh my gosh, you're still following me? You really are, aren't you? great. Here it comes. Here it comes. Stop. Ah! Jeez, that hurts. Okay, you know what? No, I can't. I can't fight him. I can't fight him or I'm gonna die. Oh, no. I'm just dead. Ah! Okay. Out of here. I'm out of here. This is not going well. My shield's almost dead. Go away, Keese. Oh no. Okay, so new shield, I guess. I mean, they're not very good shields, so it's not a huge loss, but wait, did they stop? Oh my gosh, they stopped. Holy crap. This is dangerous. This is a dangerous place that I'm in. Okay, we should be able to make it. Oh, there's another Minotaur over there. We are absolutely not fighting him in the cold here. Not just yet. Oh. Can we see the maze? Oh, is that the maze? That looks as cool as I was hoping it would. Yeah, we're definitely going there next. We're obviously not supposed to be over here yet, but I don't care. I don't care at all. No. Stop crouching! Stop, Link! You're almost there! Just grab it! Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, Link, you're gonna kill me. Okay, can I warp there now? I can. Let me get out of here then. Okay. We can warp there. We're good. We're good now. Nothing to worry about anymore. I'm pretty sure I don't have any more berries left, so if I got hit by one of those arrows, I think I'd just be dead. Since Mipha's blessing isn't ready yet. I did not want that to happen so close to victory. Okay. I'm really hoping that this maze is not in the cold zone. Really hoping. If it is, we're just gonna have to go somewhere else, I guess. More Minotaurs. I do not have the ability to deal with that. Are they just a regular enemy here? Okay, it's time for our next food. Okay, we actually do have more... quite a few more fairies. Okay, so in that case, we need to eat more food. What are we gonna eat? Man, I really don't want to have to waste so much of this food, but... we will. We're gonna do it. We're already here. And maybe at some point we'll get something that will completely invalidate the need for that food. And at that point, it will have been wasted. So since we have it, we might as well use it. So much running through empty areas in this game. I really do wish I had a horse I could call on, like so. I'm sure we do at some point. I'm sure there's a way to get that. Just I don't have it yet. So it's a lot of just running and running and running. It's like playing Elden Ring without a horse. It's a similar kind of vibe. Although I guess, I don't think Torrent is actually a horse, so. North Lome Labyrinth. Okay, it is actually still cold here, huh? You who have reached this point, proceed onward through the maze and you will receive a blessing as a reward. Okay. Before anything else, we're saving. Let's see how this goes. We got 6 minutes. Plus whatever other food we decide to use, probably 20 extra minutes worth on top of that. The get our way out of this maze. It should be enough time. Just depends on how much of that I want to waste. Searching. Oh, actually, hold on. We can cheat, can't we? So, what is the way... Where are we actually trying to reach? That's the question. Where am I trying to go here? I guess it's not totally clear, huh? The way we're going is not a dead end. So this is the larger middle part of the area. Goes all the way around, but we can't get past here. So I guess we're supposed to get all the way to the other side of the maze. Is that the idea? Okay, then it seems like I can just go this way and this way and this way. That's suspicious. Weird. Wait, I can climb the maze? Well, unfortunately it's too tall for that to be useful, but... Okay, we're definitely gonna run into enemies here at some point. Yep, hello. Keep bonking them into the wall. As long as we don't bonk him into another one of his friends. I think I hear somebody else moving though. Okay, next weapon, double axe. Yep. Okay, we good? We done? We are. All right. What do we get for our troubles? Flint, a spear, arrows. Okay, not ideal. Wait, what does that say to pick up? What does that say to pick up? Oh, the barrel, right? Yeah, just the barrel. Okay, we don't care about that. So I would love it if they gave us stronger weapons to attack these guys with when we killed them, but it is what it is, I guess. All right, get over here. Come on. Get over here. You really not see me? Hold on. Can I switch to wearing my full stealth gear? Is that a valid option? No, it's not. It's not a valid option. So I actually do need this. Okay. But maybe we can stealth through here. Is that a fire arrow? No, meteor rod. A magical rod that can cast 3 fireballs at once. Crafted by an ancient magician, it will break upon running out of magical energy, so make it last. I can't carry it, though. Okay, so let's drop something. What can we drop? The spear that we just picked up. Okay. You didn't see me. Oh, great. Never mind. You saw me. Is this a good spear? No, it's not. Well, it is, but also no. Great. This is bad. I don't want them to be angry at me just yet. I feel like they're guarding something important. I feel like I kind of do have to go past them there. Maybe I'm wrong. Let's see. See if I can get rid of them somehow. There's one over the right, but is there one to the left? Yes, there is. Okay, hold on. What's our strongest weapon? This thing. Nice. Worth it, I think. Cool. Lazal's shield. Common shield found amongst the Lavals. I try to speak too fast and it completely murders me. A common shield found among the Lazalfos. It's made of metal, but its sloppy craftsmanship offers poor durability. Okay, but I can't carry it right now. And a boomerang. Okay, hold on. Let's drop our really bad shield that we just got. We don't need that. Okay, so, and then the boomerang. Is the boomerang better than stuff we've already got? Is it better than... I don't know. I'm not gonna worry about it. Okay, is he gonna look a different way? What is happening to him over there? Is he getting frozen? Nope, you didn't see anything. You didn't notice anything. Okay, well, let's see what happens here. What are you doing? What? Okay, I mean, that's useful. That's doing some good stuff. This is fine. We're making it work. So, okay, this thing's energy regenerated. I see. He's gonna turn around before we can reach him. Oh, no, we're good. Okay. So, let's switch to... I don't think using the long blade is necessary here. Let's try the Thunder Spear. Okay! I mean, that certainly worked. Jeez. Okay. Steel Lizalbo. That's a strong one. This bow is wielded by Lizalfos, who are expert marksmen. The metal that reinforces much of the weapon adds some additional weight, but offers heightened durability. I can't carry it, so let's drop something. We've never gotten a chance to use the Lionel bow yet, which is kind of sad. We probably should try using that at some point. It wastes 3 arrows. Why would I want to waste so many arrows? Okay, let's open this up. Edge of Duality. I'm glad I went through here. A curious double-edged sword crafted using Sheikah technology. It was originally made for Hyrulean knights unfamiliar with single-edged blades. My inventory's full. I don't care that my inventory's full. I'm needing that. So we're gonna get rid of... Do we drop this? I guess we do drop this. Then we open it. Okay, well, we've got a new strongest weapon in our arsenal. That has been the katana, or the eightfold long blade, for such a long time, but now we've got a new strongest weapon. Let's see. I'm going to switch to the giant boomerang for now. So, that was not necessary for progression to go over here, but I'm glad we did. See what else we can do. We got 30 seconds left on our current thingy. So we're gonna have to use more food here in a second. Okay, I need to go over there. Don't notice me. You didn't see anything. Okay, never mind, you saw something. I'm out of cold resistance. I need to eat again. Let's see. I guess I'm using the 10-minute one. And then also, before anything bad happens, I'm saving because that was a lot of progress. Yep, there we go. Good. Nice. Dead. Okay, cool. Phew. Alright. Everything's all good. This has been profitable so far. All we've had to spend has been some cold resistance food, and we've gotten an item that already makes this worth it. Surprising lack of enemies in here, actually. There's fewer enemies in here than I would have expected. Thought it'd be a gauntlet going through this maze, but it's not the case. Okay, here's another altar type area with a chest. Okay. What do we got? Did we miss one of these areas? I feel like we might have missed the southern one. But I could be wrong. I'll be sure to make sure before I leave this place. Oh. What? There's mimics in this game? Stop it! You jerk. Wow, okay. Well, now I know. Now I know that there are fake chests in this game. I was not expecting that to be a thing. Octorok eyeballs can only be obtained from an Octorok type enemy. You can sell it to a store, you can make elixirs with it. Yeah, may have other uses. Sure. Okay, it only gave me some green rupees. I was hoping since it was a pretending to be a chest, it would have some good loot, but whatever. It is what it is. Now we know. Looking around. Okay, we're at the very edge. What am I actually? I'm supposed to be getting to the center, right? So there should be a way around here. Oh, this way. Right, this should lead me there. Oh, here goes all the goop. So I'm gonna assume I need my bow to shoot an eyeball somewhere. If I can find it. There it is. Nope, we're not using that arrow, and we're not using that bow. We're using, what, this bow, I guess? There you go. Oh, that was some lag. Also, how many arrows does that make? How many do we have? 60, wow. Okay, we're in a really good spot. I am very happy with that. So, again, before I continue on, and go into the shrine. I'm gonna check the southern area first. Just to ensure that I've gotten everything that there is to see. Yeah, the fact that we have a map view makes this very easy. To actually figure out where you're going. Nope, stop climbing. Let's just see. Okay, here we are. This is the... Okay, there is something here. I'm glad I decided to come check. Ice arrows. Okay, worth it. As expected, a somewhat smaller reward for the first chest that you're supposed to be picking up. But that's not a big deal. Over here. Did I just see something? Wondering what this area is for. Just empty. Weird. I wonder if there is anything upwards. Like, there's all these little overhang spots, but I wonder if there's spots that you can actually climb up to. That would be very evil to hide something like that in here, where you had to be looking up to find it. There's always all these little cubbies like that. What if there was one of those, but a little bit higher up? You just never find it. When did this chest get here? Excuse me? Gold rupee. 300 rupees. It's radiant golden shine illuminates your soul. Okay. I'll take it. I don't mind that. Again, we've got access to infinite rupees at this point, but that's still good. It's still a useful thing to have. Okay. How do I get back in there? Because we killed the eyeball thing, right? Do I have to... Wait, did I mess up? Do I have to go all the way back around? What did I do wrong here? I'm a little confused. What am I missing? Let me go back to where I first came out, right? What am I missing that I need to do here? So this is where I came from, right? I came out of here... And then I shot the eyeball somewhere. Where was that? Where did that happen? Was it right here? I think it was. But now I still need to get into there. How do I get into there now? This is a problem. We got 4 minutes to figure that out. Make sure I save. Is there something else I needed to activate? Like, am I missing something? I hear somebody over this way. Let me look around. There must be some other mechanism that I needed to activate that I've missed in this maze. I feel like that's probably the case. I think I'm going the right way now? I think so? I think I'm getting towards something I haven't been to before. It's super confusing. Yeah, there's something over there. Hold on. A ladder? There is stuff that's up. So that's why the geometry is so strange of this place. Okay. What? Lightning choose. Okay, so save again. Not deal with that just yet. Let me see where this leads. Okay, we got some parkour to do, I guess, but... Oh no, it's right down there. It's right below us. Okay, well before then, before we jump down there, we are gonna deal with the chews first. I feel like that's the right thing to do. Because they seem to be guarding something, and I'm not sure what that is. So, can we use Magnesis on it? We can. Nice. Up again. Back and drop. Good. Magnesis again. Up, forward, and nope, missed. Up. And drop. Okay, and there's just one left. Go back here. Come on. And over here. And drop. Okay, we're gonna need to eat more food. Our last cold resistance dish. Yellow chew jelly. A jiggly substance that came from an electric choo-choo. Electricity pulses through its gelatinous mass. If struck, it will explode in a burst of electric current. Very cool. Oh, we broke it, didn't we? Yeah, I did. Oops. I didn't know that was a thing. But I guess that makes sense. Alright, what did we get for our trouble? Knight's Shield. A shield favored by the knights who serve the Hyrulean royal family. Yeah, I think we've seen that before. We have like two of them, I think. And yet, no matter what kind of shield it is, they all seem to break pretty easily. So, I don't know if that's that big of a prize, but we'll take it. Still a good item. I just don't know if that was worth using our last cold resistance item for 12 minutes. Especially considering we're about to go into a shrine here, possibly. Wait, hold on. That goes somewhere. That's suspicious. Yeah, that is suspicious. Hold on. We're not done yet. We are not done yet. What do I want to eat here? I need to eat something. Seared steak. Okay, that's fine. Okay, where are we? Nice! 3 chests! Now, the question is, what is actually in these chests? Is it actually something useful? Topaz! Got Okay, at least it's something that's not something we'll fill up our inventory with. Ruby. Okay, precious gems are good. Sapphire. Alright, I'm happy with that. It's not like it's a weapon or a shield that I can only carry a limited amount of. Okay. Kazatoki Shrine. So, my question is, does that open up the grate? It does! Okay, great. Pun not intended. So, before I go in there, is there anything I want to do with my current remaining cold resistance? I don't think so. I could fly to other various places, but I'm not going to. So, let's just go in here. We're just gonna have to cook more cold resistance food later. And we'll get to that eventually. For now, let's try out the shrine. I'm assuming it's just gonna be another shrine that gives us an orb, but we sure did have to do a lot to get here. Although, what's this? Maybe it's not. Barbarian leg wraps, attack up. Interesting. These leg wraps were favored by a warlike tribe from the Faerun region long ago. They're adorned with traditional markings that bolster your fighting spirit to raise your attack power. Okay, that's actually a good find. So that doesn't increase our stealth, but increased attack power is not something that we have a lot of. That could be really helpful, especially in a situation with items that have limited durability, or if I'm in a boss battle. You've done well to arrive. Yes, yes, yes. Spirit orb. Okay. You know what? I'm happy with that. I was expecting a trial where I had to actually do something, but I guess that came beforehand, right? So I guess there is one thing I could do with my remaining time that I have. What I can do is I can warp back here and go down here. And I can see if I can find the other shrine that the guy was talking about. At least I assume there's a shrine there, because he was talking about two places where friends of his died a long time ago. And the other one was, they fell off the cliff. If you befriend a dog, it may lead to something interesting. That's something I haven't done yet. I'm assuming it will just lead me to a place where it's going to dig something up. Or something will be hidden in the ground. I can't imagine there would be anything too crazy, but it's something to keep in mind. So this is a dog, right? So if I, can I befriend this dog by giving it something? What would the dog even want? Some type of food? Like, would it want a skew? Okay, I can't hold this out for it though. So I'd have to give it, what, a berry? Or something? What does this do? No special effects. Okay, well then let's try giving it to the dog. Do you not care? Oh, no, you do. You care about the berry. Alright, well the dog's happy. It's not leading me to anything, but the dog's happy now. So I guess that's its own reward. Alright, bye-bye, doggo. So, the direction we're going is... Yes, correct. So, let's just keep going. Follow the path.